When you're dealing with the healing of infidelity, whether it be addiction or whether it be acting out with emotional or physical affairs or even financial infidelity, the power is truly in the process that you utilize. Now, for me, I was a quick fixer. I still sometimes can be that way in all areas of life. I want a quick fix. And when we started to try and heal from my infidelity, Samantha and I kind of fell prey to that mentality that was really my fault. I wanted to make it go away, fix it really fast, get over it, not have to talk about it. You know, I was looking for the three-step process to fix your infidelity, heal your marriage, and be done within, you know, 60 days. And so often we, whether we're unfaithful or betrayed, want it to just go away. The problem is you have to have a process. A process is just a series of events or tasks that need to be done to accomplish a goal. And when you're dealing with infidelity, it's equally true. You must have a process. If you don't have a process, the whole thing gets very muddy. It gets very insecure. It's unpredictable enough, even when you have a good process. But without a process, the unpredictability of recovery from infidelity is off the chart. It's essential to have a process. I've said it in so many of my videos that the power truly is in the process, because when you're trying to heal from something as devastating as infidelity, you may gain 2 steps one day, the next day it's like you slip slide 20 steps, right? And then there are days where you feel like, man, I feel like we've moved a country mile down the road. The sun is shining. I feel warm and beautiful and healthy. And then within 3 days, you can want a divorce all over again. I mean, it is a process. And anybody that thinks that there is just this secret wand or magic wand that you just wave over your spouse and everything's great has never been through infidelity. The wonderful thing about a process is it doesn't hurry recovery work, but it does expedite it, and it keeps you on a pathway minimizing unnecessary problems and collateral damage. A process also helps with vision and clarity. Although it doesn't fix everything and it doesn't magically make all the pain go away, it does create vision. It does create what you should expect. It helps you make sense out of your reality right now, and it gives you a future vision that you can look at and say, you know, okay, this makes sense. I have a framework to utilize to evaluate my situation right now. I have a framework that gives me hope for the future, because I can rest in the fact that although there are going to be 1,000 good days and 10,000 bad days, and then there'll be another 10,000 great days and a few bad days, I don't have to micromanage one day. I can rest in the entire process and know that I'm gaining ground. If I continue to micromanage and try and make decisions on good days or bad days, I mean, I make myself just exhausted. And I continue to struggle with gaining momentum. But when there is a process involved, and a good process is going to address 3 recoveries. If you're trying to give your marriage a chance, there's 3 recoveries that have to be addressed. There's the unfaithful's recovery, there's the betrayed's recovery, and then there's the potential recovery of the relationship. And a good process will address all 3 of those recoveries in a way that keeps you moving forward even on bad days. So today I want to ask you a few questions that will maybe help you identify whether or not you're using a process, or why you need a process, or quite honestly, and at some level I mean this sincerely, maybe the process that you're using isn't actually the best process for you. For starters, do you have a process? You know if you have a process because you understand that you're not going to constantly reevaluate the status of the relationship based upon one day or another. You know that you have a process when you have a framework to go back to on bad days. Or, quite honestly, even on good days, you have a framework to say, look, today was a great day. It doesn't mean everything's fixed. It doesn't mean that I'm just jumping back into this relationship. But it does mean that I have hope and I feel like we're going somewhere. What is your process? Is your process addressing the three recoveries that I spoke of? How is it approaching those three recoveries? Or are you alternatively just kind of doing some counseling or meeting with some people from church? Or are you just kind of reading books and just kind of winging it? Because I can promise you, if you're just winging it, there's not going to be a lot of clarity, there's not going to be a lot of hope, and there's not going to be a lot of momentum. What is your process? Can you identify it? Number two, who has designed that process? If it's someone who's never been through infidelity before, that's a huge red flag. If it's someone that's maybe been through infidelity once, but has just kind of moved on and isn't necessarily an expert in recovery, I hesitate that that's the right process for you. If it's someone who is just a general counselor or therapist, again, it's a red flag. Someone who designs your process needs to be an expert. They need to have gone through it themselves and been in the business of working with those in crisis due to infidelity or addiction, I would say at least 10 years. In many ways, whoever is designing the process for you is an essential ingredient to your recovery process because you want to know that what you're doing works. You want to know that what you're implementing is a valuable and proven approach to the trauma that you are wrestling with. This is a little tricky with a couple of nuances to it, but who's running the process? If the unfaithful spouse is in charge of what recovery looks like, it's a red flag. Because most of the time, early on, we are control freaks as unfaithful spouses. We want to be in charge of what we do, where we're going to go, what therapist we see. And honestly, I will say this because I experienced it in my own early recovery. We want to go easy on ourselves. We want to make it as easy as possible for us. We want to cut corners financially. We want the cheapest and the most effective way to save our marriage and get healthy. But who's in charge of the process? Is it a qualified expert or is it someone who is untrained or has very little training or experience or has never been through infidelity before? Because that's very concerning. If it's the betrayed, that's also somewhat concerning if they are not subjecting their process to a sense of authority in terms of a therapist who can help guide them, because sometimes there can be expectations put upon the unfaithful that are just unreasonable. Sometimes anger wins the day when the betrayed spouse is in charge of what it looks like. And I say all this with great humility to the fact that if you go to affairrecovery.com, there's a free online boot camp. It's a wonderful process. It's a 7-day free program that you can utilize. And you may say, look, 7-day program, is that really a process that we're going to use? It's a great start. And if you do that and you like that, then you'll probably want to take one of the online courses, which again are wonderful, wonderful processes for either one of you or even for both. So I'm not sitting here trying to be critical of other processes that are out there. I'm wanting to give you some solutions for your recovery as well. Another question that can seem a little bit tricky is, how long have you been using this process? If you've been using it for 10 years and there's not a lot of fruit or momentum, something's wrong. If you've only been using it for 2 weeks, maybe you did one of our courses or boot camp and you say, oh, I hated that. Day two was terrible, blah. Okay, that's fine. It's only day two. Why don't you do the whole thing and then reevaluate it? You see, good processes take time to work. Good medicine takes time to work. So how long have you been using the process? I want to err on the fact that some of you have been trapped in processes, if you will, that have not been very effective, and you've been trying to use it for months and even years. There's a point where you say, this isn't working, not the relationship, the process. Maybe it's time that you invite an expert into your situation, and maybe you make an investment that even causes some debt to be able to find a process that you can rest in and rely upon and trust in with all of your heart to bring clarity and insight to both of you. I already alluded to this, but I'll ask you again. What is the fruit of the process that you're using right now? If the fruit of it is alarming, if the fruit of it is causing you great concern, I wonder if the process is right for you. If the fruit of it is, hey, we're doing pretty well, there's positive momentum, I don't want to jerk with the system or the process that we're using, then fantastic. Keep using that process. If it's not broke, don't try and fix it. You can always help the process by continuing to learn and grow and use resources that complement the process that you're using. But if the fruit of it is frustration and anger and resentment and constantly feeling like you're stuck, it may be time to look for a new process. Finally, and I say this almost every opening day at the EMS weekends that we do, are you all in? Because you may have a fantastic process from some of the best therapists or coaches in the entire country who have been through infidelity and have treated it for 30 or 40 years. But if you're not all in, don't expect the process to work. Don't expect the principles and the tools in any process that you've learned in any area of society to be effective if you're 1 foot in and 1 foot out. If you do a little bit of work and then you pull back and don't do any work, I'm sorry, the problem is probably not the process, it's lack of effort. So I want to ask you, whether you're looking for a new process or frustrated with the process that you're in, or you don't have any process at all, are you all in? Because if you're not all in, it's not going to work. I just want to challenge you to be courageous and go all in. You're not going to regret it. I'm not saying go all in to the relationship because it may not be safe enough. But I am going to tell you that if you'll find the right people, they'll give you the right process, and then you can jump all into the process and trust the people who are utilizing that process to help you find clarity, to help you find answers, to minimize collateral damage, to provide fresh hope and fresh vision, and quite honestly, give you some insight on what your future can look like. See, the right process is a breath of fresh air for both spouses, not just one. It may be more uncomfortable for one spouse early on, but whoever you are, uncomfortable spouse, if you'll commit to that process, I promise it will get easier and it will get, in a way, more freer, if you will. It will help you feel unchained. It'll help you feel safe. And you'll be thankful that you gave the process a chance to work, not just in your spouse or your partner, but in your own heart. You see, a good process confronts you, and a good process comforts you.